it's Curt in the Top Corner Hockey Studios, Top Corner Hockey on Facebook, Top Corner Curt on Instagram. A couple of things on the weekend that I want to touch on here today. First thing is the game on Saturday night between the Maple Leafs and the Canucks. I thought it was a heck of a hockey game. I loved it. A lot of speed, a lot of emotion, a lot of goal scoring. Vancouver Canucks came into the game scoring diddly squat. They got 3 goals in the match. Hopefully it turns things around for them offensively. The Maple Leafs played a really exciting game. They were fast. They were all over the ice. They demonstrated a lot of skill. They're fun to watch these days, and they picked up their 3rd straight win. However, a lot of people are talking about still the hits that happened in the 3rd period. Let's look at both of them. First one, Morgan Rielly, former Moose Jaw Warrior. I love my former dubbers. He comes across and drills Yannick Hansen at center ice. I thought during the play this was a clean hit. A few days later, I still think it's fine. Hansen has his head down. Rielly comes in, creams him shoulder to shoulder. Hansen's head kind of snaps during the contact, and that confused a lot of people during real time, but you can really see it here. No contact to the head was made. Now, usually when a player passes a puck, you get a steamboat after where you can still make contact. You can see here, one steamboat, puck is off his stick, it's going to a teammate through center on his left. Rielly now makes contact, real good hit, and I think it's still a good hit from Morgan Rielly. A couple seconds later, the puck goes down the ice, Daniel Sedin has it in the high slot, he wires it top corner, real great shot over Frederick Anderson. Nazem Kadri comes through and drills him, and it's very similar play. I think Kadri comes through, it's shoulder to shoulder. You can see when Dank makes is nailed here, his helmet comes flying off. He twists his body, his gloves go towards his chest, and he lands on his chest. As he does that, I think his forehead bonks off the ice. That's what causes some pain. A little bit of injury here from Dank. And Hansen comes in after just getting creamed a couple seconds ago, and he comes rushing in to fight Kadri. I thought that was a great response. Very entertaining stuff. We'll see how things go. We'll see how Vancouver and Toronto match up next time they meet early December. But I thought the Saturday night game in Toronto was an awesome, awesome hockey game. The next thing I want to talk about is what's happening in Winnipeg with the Jets. At the start of the year, they decided to roll with 2 rookies in net, Connor Hellebuyck and Michael Hutchinson. Now, I'm a fan of both of these guys. However, I think it's really strange that the Jets decided to go with 2 rookies in net to start the season when they were coming into the season with some promise. It's just against the grain on everything that's tried and true with netminding in the NHL. Who in their right mind rolls 2 rookie goalies when you don't have to? It's just unbelievable that the Jets management decided to go with this. I mean, you really have to scratch your head and contemplate why the Jets would go with 2 rookies. They've got Andrei Pavlik. They decided to send him down to the Moose in the A, and he's doing okay down there. But why let him go down there when you have the ability to bring him up and send him with one of the rookies? Make the choice. Maybe later in the season, there's an opportunity for the Jets to go with the 2 rookies. But at the start of the year, I think it was a dumb choice to go with Hellebuyck and Hutchinson off the bat. Now let's take a look at their numbers. Hellebuyck is 3-4-1, 304 goals against, and a 900 save. Not awesome. Not terrible, but definitely not good. Hutchinson, 2-3-1, 319 goals against, an 896 save. Those numbers are not good. Definitely not NHL, consistent NHL stopper numbers. Pavlik is doing okay, as I said, in the A. He's got 3 wins and a 315 goals against and a 913 save. Not awesome, not terrible. Yeah, it's the A, but I think his numbers would be pretty similar because he's a veteran. His numbers would be pretty similar if they brought him up to the NHL. I think it's definitely time for the Jets to pull the plug on this rookie experiment, bring Andrei Pavlik back to the big club, send one of the young guys down, and hopefully turn around their goaltending situation that's happening in Winnipeg. Because right now, the Jets, -7 in goal differential, only the Arizona Coyotes, the Philadelphia Flyers, and the Calgary Flames have allowed more goals this early season than the Winnipeg Jets. As I said, I love my dubbers. I want to pay tribute to a former dubber right now. Marek Svatos played a couple of years in the Western Hockey League with the Kootenay Ice. He won a Memorial Cup in 2002 with that great team that the Ice put on. It had Jarrett Stoll, Duncan Milroy, had Nigel Dawes, BJ Boxmo was the goalie. I remember those days really well. It was a good time to be in the Western Hockey League, and the Ice were a class team and still put on a good product on the ice. Svatos ended up scoring 118 points in just 92 WHL games. He was drafted in the 7th round by the Colorado Avalanche. Had some good years in Colorado. His best was right after the lockout when he produced 32 goals in 61 games. It was really bizarre to find out that he passed away at just 34 years of age, leaving behind a wife and two children. You'd think that someone who's been a pro athlete in their life, that they would be in tip-top shape, even though he hasn't played pro hockey in a couple years. Really surprising. At the time of this recording, I don't have any details regarding his passing. Certainly a surprise, a shock, and sad news to find out about Marek Svatos' death. Speaking of remembering, of course, this Friday, November 11th, is Remembrance Day. I want everyone to put on a poppy. I consider myself very fortunate to be living in Canada. I think that we're lucky to have the freedoms that we have. Whether what side of the political spectrum you're on, doesn't matter. Please remember to put a poppy on. We wouldn't be sitting here. We wouldn't have the freedoms. I wouldn't be able to produce these videos. You might not have the type of career and lifestyle that you have if the guys that went to war did not do that kind of stuff. It's really important to learn about the First and Second World Wars and, of course, other conflicts that involved Canadian and the wars, because it's really shaped what type of world we're living in today. I'm Curt. This is Top Corner Hockey. Thanks for watching. See you next time.